So 2023 has been a tough year for the tech market, but something strange is happening right now that you probably want to pay attention to if you're trying to get a job. Meta and Netflix have recently been ramping up their hiring dramatically, which is far different from the case at most other big tech companies like Google and Amazon, which both have been very conservative in hiring in 2023. This points to what could be a shift in the tech job market. Now, this is far from a guaranteed sign, given that the hiring bar for software interviews is still at an all-time high, and job postings for tech are nowhere near 2022, not even pre-2020. So today, I wanted to dive into a couple of things. The state of the software job market and layoffs at the end of 2023, what the people online are saying about the job market, and most importantly, what the trends and the data show us for what the software job market will look like in 2024. My name is KC. I've been a software engineer for about 6 years, and here are my thoughts based on my research. So let's start by discussing the general online consensus of how people are feeling about the job market. It's important for us to cover online discussions because if you're watching this video, you probably browse through a lot of these online forums yourself. And usually, if you're like me, when you browse through these, you're gonna feel some sort of way. You're gonna either feel really hopeless, or you're gonna be filled with pride or something else entirely. And it's important to discuss all of those feelings. So I've aggregated a bunch of Reddit posts to generally describe the thoughts of the online world right now about the software job market. The first group is the doom and gloom crowd, which are the ones that think that it is literally impossible to get a software job right now. It will never get better, and the industry is going to be completely screwed and in decline. So I want to bring up this Reddit post. So this Reddit post is generally reflective of that first group we were talking about. Why is it so hard to get a software job? So generally in this thread, there are people who are experiencing a lot of pain in the process. Let's look through some of those comments. There's a lot of people trying to get in, not enough jobs for all of them. It's hard to get a job now in general because of the part of the economic cycle we're in. It's not just in tech, but overall. It is saturated. Generally, these are all new grads or people trying to break into the entry-level software job market, and it is undeniably tough. It's gonna take a lot of effort to break into the software industry right now, especially if you don't have any experience. And currently, the only real way through that is through leak coding, to work on side projects, to network, and to apply to lots and lots of jobs. Okay, so the second group of people that form a overall consensus online are the groups of software engineers that generally skew older. These are the ones who went through either the 2000s dot-com crash or the 2008 financial crisis, or both, and are saying to everyone, this market is nothing compared to that, or something of that nature. Let's take a look at some of these posts surrounding that topic. So this is a pretty simple post. Is this job market worse than 2008 and 2000? And from here, we can pretty quickly see the opinions of people who went through that era. 2008 was bad. People can at least get a job in retail right now. But back in 2008, you had people with degrees struggling to exist that couldn't even get a job in retail restaurant. People were desperate to put anything on the table. This one is especially angry. I don't want to be a dick, but we have reached such crazy level of delusion in the sub. No man, this is not even close to it. So this guy's obviously very angry at things. And here's a post about the dot-com bust specifically. For the older devs, how does the current job market compare to the 2000s dot-com bust? Back in the dot-com bust, it was way worse. I graduated from one of the top CSCE schools, and many brilliant friends couldn't find work. Older friends who already had jobs were laid off and went without work for a year, only to eventually get jobs paying half their original salary. Many thought it was the end of growth in tech. I was lucky. I was working through college for a company that didn't grow rapidly during the boom, so I had a job. This job market is nothing in comparison. Pretty strong opinions, but it begins to paint a picture of how different this current market is. Let's look at another one. I went to college in 01 and tried to get into what was then a web development program called ISNT. The advisor had a very serious chat with me and said, "We have a full program and 40% of the industry is unemployed. There are no jobs out there for any of our graduates. I strongly recommend you consider other options." And this is kind of the root of what this second group of people online are talking about. The job market now isn't great for software engineers, but it is nowhere near how bad it was in 2008 and 2000s. And the people who lived through those job markets feel very, very strongly about it. But in a lot of ways, we don't even need to take their word for it. We can bring up raw statistics. So this is a chart of the unemployment rate from 2000 to 2023 in Silicon Valley. So what we can see from this chart was that unemployment was very high following the dot-com boom at 8.4% in the Santa Clara County, but even higher after the 2008 financial crisis, peaking at 11% in that same county, and even higher than that after the COVID pandemic lockdowns, peaking at 12.2% in that county. And if we look at today's numbers, even though we are on an uptrend, we are nowhere near the levels of the pandemic, the 2008 financial crisis, or the dot-com bust, sitting at just a little over 3.5%. So even though it feels really bad right now, the data does show us that the people on Reddit are probably right. Things were way, way worse back then. And then lastly, online, we have the third group of people creating a consensus, which are the ones in the middle. These are generally the people with 2 to 6 years of experience in software who all agree that the past year and the half year before that have been just absolutely rough for software. But given the last half of 2023, there's been a shifting opinion that things are probably getting a little bit better. But before I talk about the opinions of that third group, let's go through some cold hard data to show just what the state of the software job market looks like at the end of 2023, like right now. So according to the Federal Reserve economic data, you can see here on this chart that plots the number of software development job positions open on Indeed, that there was undoubtedly a massive bubble in 2021 and 2022 for the tech job market, where posts for software development positions just reached an all-time high before just quickly dropping off. This is also further reinforced by a chart from TrueUp, which plots the number of tech jobs open, where we can see the open tech jobs peaked around March, April of 2022 and crashed down significantly since then. But you can see something that's very promising in the chart. You can see now at the end of 2023, the number of tech jobs is no longer decreasing, but it's stabilizing. And it's actually slightly improving, with the number of tech jobs hovering around 185,000 now. In addition to that, you can see very clearly that the number of tech layoffs has been decreasing dramatically over the course of the year as well, with December of 2023 having the lowest amount of tech layoffs we've seen since the beginning of the year. And this other chart from layoffs.fyi shows us the exact same trend, with again, December of 2023 now being an all-time low for the layoffs. So currently, things in the software job market appear to be stabilizing, which is a good thing. And this is where we can finally circle back to the opinions of that third group of Redditors that I was talking about earlier, the ones who believe that the tech job market is steadily improving. So let's look through some posts, generally on subreddits with more mid and senior level engineers, and see what they say. This first post is about people potentially seeing a turnaround in the market. This guy is wondering whether people have seen a turnaround because he himself has been seeing more and more emails and more recruiters reaching out. He's getting more interviews and stuff like that. And spoiler alert, it looks like this has been the case for a lot more people as well. I've definitely noticed an uptick in recruiter messages, mainly from small early stage startups though. Yeah, I think so. There's an uptick in recruiter messages. It's not a great metric, but 6 months ago, I was getting nothing in my box. We just got 4 times more headcount allocation for 2024 than we did this year, but it will continue to suck for juniors, especially bootcamp grads. This guy says, I think it's gonna turn around in February of 2024 hard. Pure gut. So of course, this is all anecdotal data, and this is all just people sharing their own experiences online, but it does help to paint as a picture that things are looking up. To add a bit of my own personal experience into the equation, I remember in 2021, when I worked for Intuit, when the job market was at its hottest, I would probably get 2 to 3 cold emails from recruiters into my inbox every day about some job opening that opened up. But for pretty much the second half of 2022, and pretty much most of 2023, I've seen pretty much 0 cold emails into my inbox. That is, probably up until about 2 months ago, when I started to see a small uptick. It wasn't like 2021 or pre-pandemic levels where I would get at least like once a day or multiple a day, but I would maybe get 1 a week, 2 a week, 3 a week, mostly for small startups like this guy mentioned. Nowhere near 2021 or pre-pandemic levels, but it's a start. And now finally, let's move on to probably the most important part about all this information. How will the software job market look in 2024? And will things get better? So predicting the future is obviously very, very difficult, but this article from interviewing.io probably does the best job we can probably get at predicting it, and to show us that things are trending in the right direction. So I want to preface that this is not a sponsored video in any way, but this platform has made so much of their data publicly available that it's just really hard to ignore. If you don't know, this platform basically sells mock interviews, which is when software engineers who are trying to interview for a real job want to get practice in. So they go to sources like interviewing.io to interview with a real trained professional in order to get feedback on their performance. And because of that, sales of these mock interviews can correlate with trends of the actual software job industry. And using their proprietary data, they've made strong predictions about what the 2024 market will look like. Their boldest prediction that they can predict with high confidence is that the software job market will return in 2024. You might ask, why? And what is backing that up? Well, the first thing is, remember that chart I showed you earlier about the number of open tech jobs and how it's slowly starting to stabilize now? Well, for the interviewing.io platform, they found that their purchases of mock interviews on their site have closely followed the job trend of open positions on the market. And you can see here, as job positions fall, so do purchases of mock interviews. And as they rise, so do purchases of mock interviews as well. And probably one of the bigger, more profound findings is that while most big tech companies are holding hiring steady with hiring freezes like Google and Amazon, Meta, in contrast, has been ramping up their hiring recently like crazy. And even if you don't trust that blog, take a look at this post on the Lead Code subreddit, where people are saying that Meta announced that they're ramping up their hiring. And if you're like, well, this is just some random dude on Reddit who's just saying things, the source actually comes from an actual recruiting operations program manager at Meta, who says that hiring is going to be significantly ramping up and, quote, January will be a busy month for us. Along with this, Netflix has also been ramping up their hiring recently in a very similar fashion, while all the other big tech companies have been holding pretty steady. So because of all this, and because of all the pressure that big tech companies hold on each other in terms of hiring and headcount, it's likely that Meta and Netflix ramping up their hiring will lead all the other big companies to follow suit soon. And because of this, there should be a domino effect in the industry, where software engineers leave smaller companies to go to bigger tech companies, which in turn need to hire more people. And this domino effect will lead to the software job market speeding up in 2024. It should, in theory, drive up the demand. And as the blog says, it is rare to see one FAANG deviate drastically from the others when it comes to hiring. So in addition to the number of mock interviews returning to the norm in 2024, we also see a couple of other pretty interesting findings. Usually, mock interviews are a way of practicing your skills, getting used to being in front of a person, getting feedback on your performance for an interview. But generally, this just correlates with people doing software interviews and not really getting software offers. But this chart, again from interviewing.io, shows that the salary negotiation requests over time has been peaking in the past couple of months, which shows that these engineers are not only doing interviews and passing interviews, they are getting offers and being able to negotiate them, which is yet another great sign of the recovery of the software job market going into 2024. But of course, at the end of the day, these are all just predictions, and no one can really say for sure how the future will look with 100% certainty. We can only look at the data and try to figure out trends. And the trends tell us that in general, if you're trying to hunt for a new position, it's going to be a good year for you in 2024. So as usual, the advice is always to keep applying to companies, keep lead coding, keep honing your skills, keep networking, keep working on your programming skills and your soft skills, and just keep going on your journey to find a job. If you like this video, you might want to check out my other video on why companies don't want to hire entry-level software engineers anymore. Thanks for watching.